Doesn't work very good.
Thank you.
All right, let's make just a quick snare out of this. Okay, quick snare loop, right? That turns into a big ball of shit real fast. My preferred cordage is catfishing bank line.
What's it called?
It's bank line for catfish. Or trot lines or whatever you want to use. Duck decoy lines, what they sell it is at like Cabela's for.
Is that similar to the survey?
It's just that. No, it's not. This cord is covered in asphalt. If you look at regular Mason's line, it's just slick nylon cord. It's too slick. And it does the exact same thing paracord does. It balls up. Nice thing about bank line, this bank line right here is a 125-pound test. If we're trapping 125-pound animals, we've already broken the rule of don't trap something that can kick your butt. Now with this line, make a snare. Maybe I'll make a snare. Looks a whole lot better, don't it? And one thing that asphalt gives us is one, it's a little bit of memory to the string. And two, when this tightens down, that asphalt's got just enough grip to hold it there, but it's not so grippy that it won't let your knot slide. And bank line, being as multi-versatile as it is, will hold just about everything you're going to do in the woods except maybe hang a hammock or something. It'll build a shelter the same as paracord will. It'll do whatever. You can fish with it, obviously. It's what it's made for. You can still take it, break it down into three strands, use it for sewing, whatever. If you paid attention to Mr. Campbell's cordage class, if you need something stronger, you just twist two or three strands of this together. This is like a 125-pound test, so if we put all that together, you know, we can get pretty strong. The other thing I like, this started out as a 50-foot piece of paracord. There's 275 feet on this roll. Notice the size difference? I get a whole lot more cordage in a roll of paracord than I can a roll of bank line than I can a roll of paracord. And I can do everything with this that I can do with this. Bow drill said, how many people use paracord? It sucks. It slips. Bank line, twisted in. Take two or three strands of bank line and twist it together into a piece of cordage. It is awesome because that asphalt grabs that spindle and spins it. There's no slippage. You can be wrong in your tension on your bow and it still works great. So, nothing come flying at me when I badmouth paracord, so I'm pretty happy about that.
And Cabela's sells that?
Cabela's, Bass Pro. Probably the fastest way to get this is order it from canteenshop.com. You have it to you in like 3 days. He's got a roll about that big around for $8 or something. It's ridiculously cheap. So, I babbled a little bit about materials for these.
Somebody, is there a dirt time special?
You'd have to talk to the owner of canteenshop.com. Oh, did he go there for it? Either way, that's my preferred cordage for this, for the obvious reasons that we just talked about. But you'll notice in my demonstration, I use this orange paracord so everybody can see it, hopefully. So,
the smell of asphalt doesn't bother the animals.
I've never, you know, a lot of people talk about smell when we talk about trapping. And this is a big problem caused by the Outdoor Life Network. That's who I blame it on. They run all these, you know, million-dollar commercials for scent blocker and scent away and scent be gone and scent something. I have never in my life had a problem trapping small game, smelling just as funky as I can after 5 days in the woods. They don't care. There's a few animals that care: canines, felines, and deer-type animals. That's it. I don't like eating canines. I don't like eating felines, and I ain't screwing with the deer in the trap. We covered that, right? And actually, that smell might keep these larger animals from wrecking your traps, which might be a good thing. So,
thank you.
And deadfalls, just basically a blunt force trauma. We're going to drop a weight on something. That's probably the most basic type of trap we can do, and we can make millions of them in no time because they're so simple. We'll get to a couple different deadfalls. I love the figure four deadfall. It's a masterwork of engineering. It's beautiful when done correctly. It just fits together and it's perfect. I'm pretty good at making one. It takes me 20 minutes to make a good one, a really good one. I mean, I can make one quick and easy in no time, but a really good one takes 20 minutes. Now, 20 minutes times 20, that's a lot of time, you know? And nobody's going to come along after your rescue and say, damn, he did a nice job on that trap. Who cares? You know? Who cares? So we're going to try to make everything as simple as possible. Now, the way we're going to select these traps, we're going to go back to our landscape and sign tracking. We're going to use what's there. If I'm in trees, I might use a spring snare where I got spring to power. If I'm somewhere where there's big flat rocks, I want to make deadfalls because it's there. Make sense? Just use what's there, you know, to select these. And the other thing we're going to select them on is the type of animal. Small animals such as, you know, the ground squirrels, the wood rats, real easy to kill with a deadfall. I've dropped deadfalls that were 40 pounds on a rabbit, and a rabbit come out from underneath it.
Oh, wow.
I've never had one caught in a snare, caught good in a snare, that come out of it. And generally, once I got them caught, they're caught. So that's one thing to think about is, you know, trap selection is going to go by our terrain and our target species. Alright, so we talked about the plain old ground snare. Let's talk about powered snares. How are we going to power this snare? What we want to do is have some kind of engine, whether it be a counterbalance, a lever, a piece of surgical tubing, that's going to give us power to lift up. However we can do that, that's all that matters. Any good trap does not depend on the power. If you notice here for this demonstration, I got this piece of surgical tubing. Again, very multi-versatile surgical tubing. What can we use this for that we already discussed?
Slingshot.
Tourniquet.
Getting water out of our transpiration bag or a C-pole is a very awesome piece of gear. What do you think that thing weighs?
No.
Don't take up any space. You know, we can make all kinds of things out of that, and I really like having a piece with me. I'm sure it's not the best slingshot band in the world, but it'd suffice for a little bit. So any way we can come up with our brains and our imaginations to make this string go up, that's all we need to do. It's a pretty simple concept, right? The system I want to talk about for a power snare is called the toggle system. It's one trigger system that we can use to make a multitude of traps. If we know one trigger system that we can adapt to a bunch of traps, we don't have to know a bunch of different traps, right? We can just use our imaginations and a little bit of understanding of how this operates and make it do all kinds of things for us, from catching small game, and I'll show you how to use it to catch fish with. And then, you know, a lot of people didn't think about that. I set it up, and by God, it worked pretty good. So we're going to do that too. Basically, the first thing we need on this toggle trap You see here on my nice chunk of ground is a forked stick drove in the ground. Now there's a trick to driving forked sticks in the ground. I know most people think, well, hell, you just drive the damn thing in the ground, right? Wrong. We got the ground. This is our ground level, right? We got our forked stick sticking out of the ground. Now this stick has to be able to hold the tension of whatever our trap motor is. Okay? Now in this ground out here, I got one in the ground. It's probably that forks are in the ground that far. This ground's like butter out here. Alright, so these continue underground out. Now if we just take that fork and drive it into the ground, this tip entered the ground here and here. So this ground here is ineffective from holding our fork because we disturbed it. This is a thing that, I mean, it sounds so simple, but this really screws a lot of people up. These points, which are way out here, need to enter the ground or they're going to exit the ground.
Yep.
So what you got to do is squeeze that in. That's why I really like green wood. Squeeze this in until you enter it where you want. Then as you drive it, it will spread out and it will be anchored because you'll have all this dirt undisturbed holding this from coming up out of the ground. Make sense?
Yeah. It won't break the stick either. All
right. So basically we get our anchor system in the ground. It's really helpful if you can find a 2x8 in the woods and a drill. Set this up. All right. So we got our fork in the ground. I got some sticks here. Now we need to make this toggle. This toggle is nothing other than a stick about yay long. So I got a stick here. That's pretty hard to make, right?
It's a lot of energy.
So I find my power source, whatever I want to use, whether it be a counterbalanced or a spring pole or however that is, and we'll look at different kinds of them when we go for a little walk here. I have a few set up. You're going to take whatever you tied up for a snare. So I'm sitting around camp, maybe boiling some water, finishing my shelter. I'm going to pull out my bank line and start making these ahead of time. So I'm going to cut it, tie my little snare loop in the end. I'll break me a bunch of little sticks off like this. Make a loop. Pull it through. That wasn't real hard to make. That's a little quicker than carving a 20-minute deadfall trigger trap, right? So I can make 20 of these in camp, roll them up, put them in my pocket. Now I'm ready to go set some traps. So I'm getting to my trapping area. I'm going to take my snare, pre-made snare. I'm going to tie it to whatever I'm going to use for a spring. Get my substantial fork squeezed together and drove into the ground. I got my toggle in here. Now all I got to do is figure out what way I'm going to trap that toggle to retain this energy. I want potential energy, which we're going to trap to turn into kinetic energy, right? There are so many ways we can do this. The simplest way, to get my hammer out here, just drive another stake into the ground. Okay? What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this toggle, catch it in my fork, all I gotta do is trap that toggle. It doesn't matter how we do it, just as long as we can release it. I'll take my extra large snare loop here, lay it over my bait stick and bait that stick. Bait sticks are a huge problem for a lot of people. Out here there's ground squirrels, I've seen some wood rats, that type of thing. They don't feed on things that lend themselves to being skewered by a stick. If you've ever tried to stick a stick through an acorn, how hard is that? It ain't very good, right? So when we do this, we gotta use a little bit of ingenuity. If we're trying to stick a stick through a nut, that doesn't work too good. Why not stick the nut through the stick? Right? Just split that stick and get that nut in there. If we do that, that makes that bait on there very secure. Now animals won't have to fight to get our bait off, which is going to give us a better chance of him setting it off. This is very easy to do.
Five alarm chili peanuts work good.
What's that?
Five alarm chili peanuts.
Yeah, they're great. Preferred bait of ground squirrel trappers everywhere. That's what I use it for.
I thought it was Southwestern because it's five alarm.
Get my workbench back here. Go ahead.
Yeah. No, I can do it later.
How we're going to do this is real easy. We're going to start with a bait stick that's way longer than what we want. Because if you cut this bait stick to size and then go to split it with this knife, I guarantee it'll split right out the end.
Yep.
That's Murphy's Law, right? So what we're going to do is use our workbench here. We're going to take our knife with the blade away from you, so if we do something stupid, it might not be as catastrophic. We're just going to start it in that stick. Spread it open. Don't want to walk around and look for whatever the animals are feeding on. Generally, if you find peanut jars, that's a good place to look. So, got my knife in there with the blade away from me. I'm just going to twist that open and get my bait in there. It's as easy as that. Now, once I got this made with plenty of length on either end, I can then trim each end to decide where I want my bait in the middle of this. That way I'm not set to a length or placement. I can trim off either end and put it where I want. Another really good way to do this is to glue it on there. You say, well, where the heck am I going to find glue? There's glue all over the woods. It's called pine tar. One thing I found a lot with nuts and seeds and stuff like that is if you break them open, it releases the smell, which makes them more attractive. If I'm in a place where there's acorns, my acorns are busted, they smell more acorny, if that's a word. So that's going to give it that
that's not the right that word.
Yeah, acorny. So what I'm going to do, take is whatever nuts and seeds I got, my little bit of pine tar. I get my multi-tool out here. My multi-tool. We're just gonna work that down like that. I'm gonna take this stick trap, put it all over my bait stick.
That's awesome.
Huh? Now I have my bait on my stick.
Wow.
It's another way to do it. I've taken my awl and made a hole in an acorn or a walnut and tied it to the stick. That just takes a little more time. And actually, I found it to be quite dangerous with an awl and a nut. And yeah, just didn't work out.
On the split stick, did you reinforce on each end of your split?
You could. Sure, you could.
That's all the original.
One thing I like to do. What would work great is that use a little bit of pine tar with it, just to pack it in there. Any way you can get that bait on this stick, that's hard to get off. If it's real easy to get off, they might not set your trigger off if you didn't set it light enough. Another thing we like to use around my house is honey locust branches. Now, you guys have honey locusts around here? They got thorns like this on them.
We have them.
And them thorns lend themselves to baiting with soft baits like berries and meat. Because we can just use them thorns to stick on our bait.
Comes with a skewer.
Anything you can come up with in your imagination, there's just a lot of imagination involved in trapping. There's no set way to do it. All you gotta do is get it stuck on there, don't matter how. Whatever bait stick in there. This is just about as simple as it comes right here. We got our bait on, our snare loop. Mr. Animal comes along, checks it out, releases the trigger. Now when setting this trigger up, there's one thing you really got to pay attention to.
And that would be the bait stick, which you're actually using right there.
Right. Get this set back here. I built this thing at home because I wanted a way to do this on the table. Because I noticed a lot of times when I'm doing stuff down on the floor in front of people, the first 10 people can see what I'm doing, the back people can't. But if you'll notice the way this toggle was caught, it's not straight up and down. There's a reason for that. Notice how it's at an angle? So it releases faster. The farther that thing's got to travel out of that fork, the slower it's going to be. And we have this at a 90 degree angle. It has a tendency for the toggle to walk. Now it's stuck. Or that knot that your toggle's stuck on will get stuck in the fork. So you always want that at just a little bit. Just like that. Now this trap system, this isn't the only way you can set it up. There's hundreds of ways. This, exactly like it is, I can make this a non-baited blind set in a trail, just exactly like this, with the addition of a treadle set over it. Obviously, I'm not going to go all out here. But I can set a treadle up. Anyways, you get the idea. We can set this in a trail with this treadle, and we can camouflage this treadle so it just looks like part of the trail.
What does that mean? An animal runs up the little ramp?
Well, generally you'd have it a little lower, but this is my supersized demonstration version.
But that's what it means, right?
Right. A treadle is just a way to make a trigger that something steps on. So then I would just put my snare in the middle of that. So when Mr. Animal comes up the treadle, he releases the trigger. Something I should really point out on this. When you're messing with this, don't go like this. That stick will put your eye out in a big hurry or crack you in the face. And you know, I've been doing this for a long time, and I'll probably crack myself in the face day when we're out doing this. So just something to keep in mind. Putting your eye out is a little detrimental to your survivability. Let's look at a few other ways.
How many times you had them bite you?
What's that?
How many times you had the traps bite you?
Oh, a bunch of times. Let's look at another way that we can use this same system. I want to make my toggle and my bait stick one piece. Pull this down, my power down to figure out where I want it. So now my bait stick and my toggle are going to be the same piece. I'm going to bait one end of it, the other side's going to be. My board's going to fly away.
You want me to hold it?
Nah. If your power is too strong and it's pulling your fork stick up out of the ground, take a little bit of the power off of it. This worked perfectly at home, I promise you.
Nobody was watching.
I should have took pictures. Yeah.
Do you want me to put a couple rocks on your fork?
Son of a bitch. Dying here.
Well, actually, it's good because it shows that even as many times as you've done it,
can't always gauge it right.
Well, you always have to finesse what he's doing.
So anyway, how I trapped his toggle was from the backside. I keep it from swinging under. I'm going to have my bait out here. And one important thing about setting this up the way it's set up is this stick here is leveraging against this stick, shoving it in the ground. What I want to do on soft ground is stick something like a rock under the back of here so it isn't sinking in the ground. The way we got it set up, we just baited it into that stick and set our loop under it. Now we got to make his proportions to the animal we're trying to trap. We want him to have to grab up, reach up, and pull on this bait. So this size would probably be good for a ground squirrel or a wood rat. If we're trying to trap something like a raccoon, we'd want it a little higher. And the idea of this setup is Mr. Animal comes along, sees the bait, reaches up, pulls on it because he wants it, right? What happens when I pull on it? Our prop stick falls away, right? Releasing our trap. It's a really, really simple way. If you notice, I haven't used any tools. You just break all these sticks, right?
Will you set that up one more time?
Yeah. Just like that. All this stick is doing is keeping it from rolling out.
Right.
So when the animal grabs the bait and pulls on it, that falls out. Release. Kind of running through a few ways to set this up just to give you some ideas and get you thinking. This isn't a set way to do it. It's whatever you come up with.
And then the loop is just right there underneath the bait.
Right, underneath your bait. And you always want your snare loop proportional to the size of the animal you're trapping. Now let's say we want to set some bank lines for fish. That's something very common where I live in the river bottoms. We'll set out bank lines and tie them to a tree. And that way you're fishing where you ain't going to be there. A lot of the fish are rough fish, carp in general. And the way they'll bite is they'll come up and just mouth your bait. They'll never take it and hook themselves. So I had to come up with a way to hook a fish without being there. So what I come up with basically was to use this exact same trap. With our toggle. Set this up backwards. On this one, you got to pass it through the backside. Then I'm going to take my stick, which is going to act like our bait stick, but it's not going to be baited. I'm going to jam it in the ground. Catch that toggle, right? And this is my fishing line tied to my springy tree. I'm going to tie that with whatever tension I want to that trap stick and run my line on out in the water with my bait. Now what that's going to do for me is to set this hook so I can hook a fish when he bites on this. What it's going to do is pull that bait stick out of the way and set the hook.
Wow. Does that pull the fish out of the water too, or just hook it?
Well, if you're pulling fish out of the water, you probably used the wrong power source. Now, when I was doing this, I thought, well, you know what? I did that. It worked pretty good. Why not just make that